Alright, in this video I'm going to do an example of rewriting complex fractions. And there's two different ways that you can go about simplifying complex fractions. And again, just a complex fraction, all that is, you know, you've got a big fraction, and then within that you have even more fractions, is the basic idea. So, again, two ways to do them. One way is to look at all the denominators, and you can multiply the top and bottom by the least common multiple of the denominators, and the idea is that'll get rid of everything except for, you know, the one big fraction. Another thing is to simply write the numerator as a single fraction and the denominator as a single fraction, and then what we're going to do is just use the trick that we can flip and multiply. And that's how I've always done them, so that's how I'm going to do this example and the others as well. So we have 2 over x plus 3 divided by 1 plus 3 over x. You can think about the 1 as being 1 divided by 1. And again, what I want to do is, the numerator is already a single fraction. I'm going to write the denominator also as a single fraction. So in this case, I look at the denominators. We have 1 and x. So to get a common denominator, I could multiply the first term by x over x. And in the numerator, we'll simply leave that alone, 2 over x plus 3. And then in the denominator, we would have x over x plus 3 over x. And again, the whole reason we did that is so that we could write the denominator as a single fraction. So oftentimes, I'll even skip this step. So in the numerator of the denominator, we would have x plus 3, which we can't really do much with, divided by our common denominator of x. So this is kind of the first half of it, getting the numerator as a single fraction, and now the denominator is a single fraction. And remember, the trick is, if you have a fraction divided by a fraction, we leave the top fraction alone, and we take the denominator, we flip it over, but we turn it into multiplication. Okay, so instead of divided by x plus 3 over x, we were multiplying by x over x plus 3. And in this case, you know, if there was anything to factor and cancel, I would certainly try to factor and cancel. But in this case, in the numerator, we have a 2 times an x. In the denominator, we have x plus 3 and x plus 3. I would probably rewrite this simply as 2x, and then x plus 3 quantity squared. Again, you could multiply the denominator out, you could FOIL it out, x squared plus 6x plus 9. But I think my own personal preference would, again, just to be to leave it in this nice factored form.